it's Karen from Bobbleheadknits. It is Wednesday, July 26th. It's a very hot day here in Colorado. Yes, my hair is wet. I just got out of the shower, and in the summertime, I tend not to do my hair. I tend just to put it up when it's wet and leave it that way. I'm in the kitchen. Well, kinda. Sorry, I'm next to the kitchen, so you might hear my dishwasher or you might hear the air conditioning, so apologies. This is going to be a little bit different vlog. I wanted to record a vlog today because it's one of these rare occasions where it's very nice and quiet here. My husband and daughter are off. They went to Arizona to see a baseball game. Yes, it's 117 degrees in Arizona, but they went for baseball. So I had no interest in going, so I stayed behind. Okay, so if you're new here, this is my knitting vlog. I talk about knitting and life stuff, and that's kind of it. That's about it. Today, though, we're going to do a little bit different format because I have no finished objects to show you, and the whips I have to show you are whips that I've had for the last month. So I'm like, that's just boring. We need to do something different. So hang on. I'm drinking my water. So I have my Hanging with My Nomies and on this side Book Witch sticker on my Yeti cup. It's just ice water. I'm trying to stay hydrated, and I find myself drinking way too much caffeine and not soda, but just juice and not good things for you. So trying to be good and stay hydrated. Okay, so I'm babbling all over the place. I probably should just start this again, but I really don't feel like it. I'm just gonna babble. So a little bit different format because I have no real I have no finished objects. I have the same whips I had the last time you saw me. I decided that I would do a what's in my bag video. So I have most of my knitting bags right here on the floor next to me. They are full of projects or what they're projects that I thought in the past that I would be doing, and I might be rethinking them. I have other projects that are not in bags that are just kind of in my stash, and I know the yarns for a certain project. We'll do that video another time, but I have enough bags here to keep you entertained. So we're gonna launch into it. I did not really prepare like detailed notes, so I'm using my Ravelry. It should be pretty good because I have pretty detailed notes on Ravelry and my queue. The only bad thing is that bag makers I do not have. So I will try as best I can to tell you where I got the bag from. Also, you might hear some noise besides the air conditioning, the dishwasher, because my dogs are here. So, okay, first off, I'm just gonna grab a bag and we'll go that way. First off, I have my Hide and Hammer sweater bag. This was a collaboration that Hide and Hammer did with, Spin Cycle Yarns. Yes, so I bought the bag and I got like two skeins of Spin Cycle Yarn. Oh, this is a good one to start with, because this one I do plan on starting soon. So, apologies for the crinkles. This contains the contents of my Penguono. I'm gonna go ahead and knit the Stephen West Penguono, and I'm gonna have to move my computer closer because I can't see, and I'm trying to avoid putting on my glasses, but I might if I have to. This would be, I've got some, what is this? Haiku by Skakel? S-K-A-C-E-L. Simply worsted in the natural olive color. Hopefully that focuses. There you go. The other yarn I'm going to do is Expression Fiber Arts, and this is Tranquil DK in the cranberry sauce. There you go. I also have, hang on, I have my iPad open, and I really don't need my iPad because I have my computer here, so I'm trying to make room to put all this yarn. We have Stranded Dye Works. That is, let's see, the Merino DK in Foghar. I have no idea, you know, but it's a beautiful color. There it is. And then I'm going to try to do these all at once, and I do apologize for the crazy crinkling. Some people don't like it. I personally like it. So, all right. These are a collection from, where did I get these? McMullen Fiber Company. And these are the, hang on, I'm just gonna have to put on my glasses. Now they're all wet and stuff. Well, I guess it doesn't say what it is, but I am trying to look it up. Urban Garden is the colorway. Hang on. This is gonna be a funny video. My hair's wet, my glasses are fogging. God only knows what's gonna happen. All right, that's the Urban Garden collection, and these are minis. So all of these colors together will be in my Penguono by Stephen West. Okay, sorry for the crinkling, but I don't want to mix these yarns up, so I want to make sure that they get back in the correct bag. Also, as I'm doing this, if there's something that I see that I think I'm not going to really knit it, because some of these, like, I put in these bags years ago, and I haven't opened them, so I probably will repurpose the yarn. Okay. When I put these on, I look like my eyes are huge because they're like 2.0 readers. So, okay. Totally off topic. Okay, so that one is one we will keep because I actually think I will be casting this on sometime in August so that it's ready for cold weather. Okay, hang on 1 second. Okay. Sorry. This next one, this one I probably will do too. I will keep it. This was in my, I don't know what this bag is or where I got it. It's just a little, like, wrist bag, like this. It's a little Japanese inspired. It's good for socks and other small projects. It does have little pockets. This one is going to be my Twixtmas Cowl by Louise Tilbrook. And I bought this yarn specifically to knit this. It's two skeins of Tint the Sleeping Air. I'm gonna hope there. Oh, yes, there it is. It's just, whoa. Okay, that is some seriously beautiful yarn. I mean, I love color, and this is why I love color. Here, let's see if I can get a better, kinda. This is it, you know, that cinematic setting. Okay, I have two skeins of this, and it's by, hold on, let me look, let me look. Oh, Bona Yarns. That's a British dyer. It's finger and weight, and Barton at Knit 365 knit this cowl using this yarn, and that's, I fell in love with it. So I'm copying him, as people are wont to do. And yeah, it's just some gorgeous yarn. I'm most definitely gonna keep that. That's a little project that I think will knit up quickly, and it probably is worth starting sometime in the next month or two. Probably sooner rather than later, because it's a lightweight project and it's small, and because it's so hot here, I really don't want to do too many big projects. So, okay, hang on, more water. Okay. Oh, another good one. This one I'm keeping. This is my, hold on, hold on. Aurora, oh, this is first the bag. Fordham and Mason. grocery, little tiny like lunch size bag. Fordham and Mason, for those of you that don't know, is a fancy grocery store in England, and I don't know if they have any outside of London, but they have at least two that I know of in London, and they carry tea and all these fancy like British biscuits and other bits and bobs, and I like to just go there and get bits and bobs and tea whenever we go, whenever we're in town. So this is, contains my Aurora Cabin Shawl by Stephen West yarn. I bought this last year. I was going to do the Hyber Knit Long, which was started in December, January, can't remember when, but at the time I was, when it came up that it was starting, it was a mystery knit along, another mystery knit along, and I was already doing the big mystery knit along that started in October, and I hadn't finished it. So I put this aside, and I said I would do it later, and I've decided, because I wasn't, like mystery knit longs. Let's just put it that way. I mean, I like the sock one because that's a little bit of yarn, right? But I don't want to spend a lot of money on yarn and then and then like start knitting something and then realize I really don't like it. So I guess I don't want to say I'll never do a mystery knit long, but I will. I'm not planning on doing the next big Stephen West mystery knit long. Instead, I'm gonna do the Aurora Cabin. And in this case, I know what it looks like, and I have the yarn, and I want to knit it. And if I decide in the end that I like the pattern for the mystery knit long for this coming year, I can make it after the fact. So let me show you the yarn I got. I did get a kit from Stephen and Penelope to do this, because it's just easier. I'm not really good at picking out colors. Like, well, I probably am really, like I probably could, but I just don't have the confidence, and I need to work on that. Like on the Penguono, I picked out those colors and I think they're gonna be okay. So. I probably will be okay with that, but I need to, work on my color selection and things. And I saw these colors and I really like them. So, and I'm trying to stick to keep the little cards or the ball bands with the colors, and I'm taking them out of their little, someone called them yarn condoms. I love that. So yeah, I'm taking them out of their yarn condoms trying to keep the low ball bands with it. So hang on while I do that, and then I will show you all the colors. And this was a kit, like I said, from Stephen and Penelope. And maybe I will get to the point where I can pick my own colors and stuff, but I mean, I am kind of on certain things I'm doing that now, but I need to work on my confidence on that. So, okay. So I got the Life in the Long Grass singles, the kit, and that's all fingering weight. And it's 1, 2, 5 different colorways. I'm gonna just hold them all up individually and then together, and so you can see. So this is the Northern colorway. There it is. These I wound because I really did think I was gonna do the knit along last winter, and I didn't. So this is the Aurora colorway. Ooh, there it is. This is the Particle colorway. This is gonna send my camera into crazy mode, I bet you. Yeah. And this is the Voltage colorway. And this is Polar Frost. I don't know if I can pick all these up at once, but I'm gonna try. Ooh, look at that. Okay, I just dropped something. Ah! This is called Juggling with Karen. Okay, I have to get that one. And now I've mixed them all up, but that's okay. I think I can figure it out. Okay, so I am going to definitely knit these when the new knit along comes out. So I'm gonna leave this together intact as a kit. I'm putting these back in the yarn condoms. These are yarn condoms that I bought. These are just polka dot ones. But I wanna make some of the Knitty Natty ones, the pattern. I bought her pattern. I have so much yarn that is just kind of scraps of, not scraps, but not enough to really do much with. So I'm gonna use those to make some yarn condoms. So here's a cute one. There's probably a better name for it than yarn condom, but that will be the name that I refer to them as only. I think it was Chevrel who calls them yarn condoms. I'm not sure. But it made me laugh. I'm missing a ball of yarn here somewhere. Did I drop two? Okay, well, I'm not going to worry about it. I mean, I will find it. There's two of them missing, apparently. It went somewhere. Oh, there it is. Hang on. It went in the pile of dog toys that I have, which could have been a big disaster if the dog had gotten to it before I did. Okay, so I know that the particle one is way over there in the kitchen, so I will get it when I clean up this mess. So, okay, next one. This is a bag. Hold on, I need to put on my glasses again. I got this this is tilcobags.com's Tika bags. The bottom is this plastic. I got this at my favorite yarn store in Colorado, Colorful Yarns, which is in Littleton, Colorado. I used to live like across the street, basically. I guess it wasn't really across the street. It was like across the parking lot from Colorful Yarns. And that's where I learned how to knit. They are just a wonderful shop. It's huge. They bought their own building and they've grown, and I love that store. I don't go there enough. Okay, this one I probably should just do because it's something that I bought when I was first learning how to knit, and I kept seeing it in the Webb's catalog, and I thought, what a beautiful shawl. It's called the Cold Spring Shawl by Kirsten Hipsky. I bought it as a kid. I mean, at the time, I was not knitting nearly as much as I am now. It was a huge, to me at the time, it was a huge investment. But I'm not knitted. So I kind of feel like I need to knit it. And it scares me a little bit, even though it's pretty basic knitting, but the yarn itself is what scares me because I have not knit with this before. So let me get it all out and then I will show you what I'm talking about. And I know a lot of you have knit with this kind of yarn before. This is Valley Yarns, and Southampton is the name of it. Let me show you. Here's this. It is, Okay, so I have three balls of this color. Okay, and this is kid mohair and mulberry silk. So the whole shawl is made out of this. So mohair and silk. Here's the other colorway. And hold on, let me tell you what this one is. It's the same everything, but the color is different. So this is color 005, which I don't have. I think it might be Sunset, but I'm not positive, so don't quote me on that. And then, hold on, something's off here on my numbers, but we'll worry about that later. And then this other one is Cranberry. So I have a bunch of, I have like 10 skeins of yarn in the various colors. So I'm not gonna hold them all up. I'll just do that for you. So it's just a very basic shawl. I mean, it's just a big rectangle. It's not gonna be hard as far as, you know, knitting it will not be hard as far as the shape of it. There's probably, it's very, when I bought it, it was for like an advanced beginner, so I'm way beyond that now. My biggest thing though is that I've never knit with mulberry silk, mohair and silk. I've never knit with that, and how tiny that is. I mean, that scares me a little bit. And you're not holding it with anything. So I'm not like holding it with regular yarn, wool. So it scares me. But I should just knit it because I've had this for a number of years. And I mean, I don't know why I've not knitted it. I need to get over my fear of it, right? And knit it. I don't otherwise have any plans for that. And it is a fall thing, so I should just do it. I can't promise that I'm gonna do it anytime soon, though. I don't know. We'll see. I'm not like, I don't feel like I should say, oh, let's just find another use for that yarn, because I don't really have another use for that yarn, so I feel like I should just knit it and get over my fear. Okay, this yarn, I have no clue what I'm gonna do with it. First of all, let me just show you. This is a beautiful handmade quilted bag that my brother-in-law made for me. My brother-in-law is a quilter. He's very talented. I mean, he's made like huge quilts, but he made me this bag because he knows I love bags, my husband told him. So I'm gonna show you this, and I don't know that this is really what it's gonna end up being, only because I look at this now and I realize what I wanted it to be is not, like, I wanted to make my husband a sweater. So I picked the Dustland sweater by Stephen West. That's not really his kind of sweater. He just doesn't, it's a little bit too fitted. The pattern's beautiful. I could make it and and make it bigger so that it's not fitted, and then he probably would be okay with it and he would wear it, but I didn't. And when I bought this, I bought it from Jimmy Bean's Wool in Reno, Nevada. I love that store. I order from them all the time. In fact, I might have some yarn coming from them. That's another story. We'll talk about another time. They were having a clearance on this because this dyer has gone out of business. She's no longer dyeing. And I bought the yarn and I ended up getting twice what I ordered. And I'm pretty sure, yeah, I accidentally put in, did I put in? No. Hang on, last time again. My big old bug eyes. So I put in double what I really needed. And so I have a lot. I have 10 skeins of this yarn. I'm gonna show you now. This is the Shibu, hang on. Okay, I don't actually have this listed on my Ravelry page, so I'm gonna have to read this, but just take a look at it there. It's Shibu Haven, and they are not dying anymore, so I have 10 skeins of this colorway, which is, let's see, this is 80% extra fine merino and 20% cashmere, so it's just beautiful. The color is Caper, and it's a DK weight. So, I mean, I have more than enough. I can knit him a different sweater, and I think that's what I'm gonna do. And so, even though I have put this yarn, my dog's over here eating, or thinking about eating the other dog's food. Even though I put this aside to make the Dustland sweater, I don't think I'm gonna make the Dustland sweater with this. I'm gonna find a different sweater. So I'm gonna put this aside for something else. I'm gonna free up this yarn bag here. I just don't feel like that sweater's the right sweater for my husband, but I do want to make him a sweater. That's a whole nother story. I was just having this conversation with him that I don't have very many knit-worthy people in my life. That's awful of me to say, isn't it? I mean, I have people in my life that I love dearly, but most of them wouldn't appreciate the amount of time and effort that goes into knitting anything. My husband actually did ask for a scarf, and I think he wanted a hat. He wanted a scarf and a hat. He does not, he told me, want socks or dishcloths. He didn't say anything about a sweater, but we'll see. He is knit-worthy, but, you know, he like sees me knitting all the time, and I don't know. I just don't like, I don't want to put a lot of effort into something and have him not use it. So I think he would most, he might wear a sweater, but I also want to make sure that, like, I want to make a few more sweaters for myself to make sure that I have it down as far as making sweaters, so that when I make his, it's so perfect and so like, wow, that he wants to wear it. So, all right, so I'm gonna put this aside. Getting back to my whole conversation about knit-worthy people. So my daughter, loved dearly, is not really, like, I would love to knit her some things, but she's very particular. She only wears certain colors, and she, like, if I made her a pair of, like, knit her some socks, she would wash them and dry them in the washing machine, in the dryer, and they'd shrink, because she's just not very aware of what goes into making hand knits and all. So maybe one day I will make her something, but not there yet. Baby Atticus is very knit worthy, but I don't know yet. You know, when you're knitting baby things, one, you have to be aware of, you know, they need to be quick and easy, washable things so that mom and dad are not left dealing with hand washing. And then he's growing so fast. Well, in his case, not super fast. He's real tiny still. But, you know, I'll probably make him some sweaters, and I have yarn to do that, so I probably will at some point. We'll do a stash tour at some point, but not today. Okay, moving on. Oh, my son and daughter-in-law. I probably would, well, okay, I've thought often about knitting them things, but the problem is, okay, my son, they mock my knitting, okay? So because of that, I'm like, yeah, I'm not gonna. My mother-in-law, I would knit things for her. I made her a Stephen West shawl last spring because I thought she would really like it. I don't know if she uses it, but it's beautiful. She's always like in awe when she sees my knitting, but you know, she's 80 something and I'm like, would she really use and knit it, whatever? So I probably will knit her some things. Okay, this next thing, actually this is something I've already talked about like recently. I actually have the needles in here already and I haven't knit it. So. Finding things in the knitting bags, I'm going, ooh. This next thing, well, I already took it all out of the bag, but I will show you. And I have no idea, let me see. This is by 65 South, and my husband and daughter got this for me. I want to say it was for a birthday. It's a Boston Terrier bag. It is so cute. I love this bag. And it's perfect, like, you know, it's a perfect size. So, it is holding, I don't even know if I have this in my queue. So hang on, let me find it. Oh yes, I do. It's the Boho Shrug by Alissa Barton. And she, I believe, is in, I wanna say she's a Colorado designer. I could be wrong. I don't know. I've talked about this. I kind of wanted to do this for this summer and I didn't, but I hope to make it for next summer. So I'll just hold up the three skeins of yarn. Let's see if you can see that. Ooh, there it is. So this is, I botched the name, so I better look. This would be strawberry. Okay, this is thistle, and this is, hold on, sequoia, there it is. So it's just a shrug, and I definitely want to make it, so I will leave this in the project bag and we will be making this. I'd like to make it like soon. I almost wonder if I should just cast that on before I do the sequoia. I don't know though, because, or not the sequoia, the begonia, because I'll finish it and then it will be too cold to wear it, maybe. I don't know, we'll see. Okay, next one. This is a bag, Plucky Kid is the designer. And actually this was the very first knitting bag I ever bought. And it's, I like it. It's, you know, very good for travel. I usually don't, unless I'm going to be, like if I'm in the car, I will bring this one because it's a perfect size. I won't fly with this because it's too big. Okay, I did this originally to do a Alaska hat by Camille Descoutu. I don't know, Alaska hat. And I bought this as a kit and it's all Freya fibers, hand painted yarn. So I have these. I'm pretty sure I'll go ahead and do this. I'm not sure if my husband would like this, but I feel like it would be a good gift, or maybe even keep it myself. I have a relative in my family, my sister-in-law, who would, I think if I did this for her as a, like a birthday gift, she would love it. She hates me though. Yeah, she actually told me that one day. So, but it's her, like I bought this with the intention of giving it to her, and even though she hates me, I think I might go ahead and make it anyways, because she's gotta work through her issues. And I'm trying to forgive her for saying that. So, it's a long story. I shouldn't be airing my dirty laundry, but leave it. Okay, so that's staying in there. Okay, next project. We're almost there, I promise. Okay, this is, it has a label but no name, so I have no clue who made this bag. It's a little triangle bag. It's beautiful. It's perfect for socks. Speaking of which, this is the yarn that I have picked out to do my next pair of socks, which, by the way, I have decided I am now a sock knitter and I'm kind of obsessed with it a little bit. I'm going to do the bookshelf socks, which are by Beccy Mundy. Sorry. She is a blogger that I follow, and I have picked out this yarn to do it with. I'm gonna show up. There it is. This is, I'm gonna botch this jean fiber. And this other one is just a little, like, what, a 20 gram ball that I got. I think I got this actually, hold on a second, let me see if I have the name. I got this when I was in Las Vegas, and I cannot for the life of me remember the dyer, and I apologize, that's awful of me, but I bought like a set, actually, hang on, I can tell you exactly who the dyer is, I do have it. It is, I got a rainbow mini set from Sin City Knits, and the dyer is, glasses. Getting old sucks, let me tell you. Oh, there was no dyer name on it. I have no clue. Anyways, so this is one of the colors that was in the bundle that I bought. And There is no purple in here, but I figured it's a huge contrast and I'm gonna do it. So it's a bookshelf yarn. As soon as I'm done with the Stephen West surprise sock along, I'm gonna knit these. So this I actually have been carrying around with me to Europe with me. I hadn't latched on to knitting fast, so sorry. So they still need work done, but they still need to be started. Sorry. Okay, this next one, I've had this for a few years. I have no idea. This is just like a mesh bag that the kit came in. I bought this at Interweave. They have a yarn festival thing in Loveland, Colorado every year. And that's where I got this. And it's just a kit, and it is for a kit for the Night Shift by Andrea Mowry. And I am gonna knit this. I actually have been thinking sooner rather than later. And the kit has 6 balls of yarn, not the spin cycle yarns that the pattern was designed for, but these are Greenwood Fibers Yakety Yak DK, and I will show you each one alone. There's so many, I don't know that I can hold up all of them at once. This is Orchid, beautiful. Raspberry, Melon. Sorry, I'm checking to see where my dog is because I felt like maybe he was getting in trouble, but he's okay. Turquoise. I have 2 dogs and they're both over there staring at me. Emerald, probably wondering who I'm talking to. And then Canary. So these will be made into a Night Shift. And I want to actually make it sooner rather than later. So I'm gonna definitely keep that in its bag. I've had this, it's been a couple years, I guess. So I will knit these up. I need to actually start knitting these things, and like they've been in my queue for most of these for a while, and I have the yarn and I need to just stop adding things to my queue and knit these. So 2 more, we're almost there. Oh, this one. Okay, this is fun. So this one is in my the bag that I got in Palm Springs this in February, the handmade knitting bag. And I cannot for the life of me remember the place that I bought it, but it was, hang on, Tip Top Totes, and it's Donna Newton made this, and it's all these dogs, so cute. And there was, if you go back, I did a video about when I went to Palm Springs. So this one is interesting because I was trying to find a use for this yarn, and hang on, I need to actually find the pattern, and I have the feeling, oh, there it is, okay. So I don't know if I'm really gonna knit this. Yeah, I think I'll knit it. So I bought, I'm sorry again for the clinking, I bought this yarn. Some of this yarn, I bought it last summer in Scotland, and not wool though. it's alpaca, and this is alpaca from Frank the Alpaca. Hang on, if you see him, there's Frank. I don't even know how to pronounce this. I will totally botch it, but it's the Hebridean alpaca company in the Isle of Skye. And Frank is the alpaca this came from. It is super soft. I really love it. But when I bought it, I bought all the Frank alpaca because there were only three skeins. And so this is not like I won't wear this color up close on my face with my gray hair because I don't think it's very becoming. But I have enough here that I can combine it with this other yarn that I bought and make a beautiful sweater. But I was worried because alpaca, when you make a sweater, like unless there's other like wool or nylon or something else in it, it tends to stretch and not really hold shape very well. So the sweater factor made me a little bit nervous with it. So I wanted something that was going to be structurally, that if it changed shape while I was wearing it or over time, I would be okay with. So I found this pattern called the Sideways Garter Vest, and I'll put a picture there, by Purl Soho. The other yarn, it's a two color pattern, as you can see. The other yarn I got to go with it is a wool, and it's a British wool and British alpaca, so it's mixed. And it's the Rowan Moordale. There it is. And this by itself would be fine as a sweater. It really would because it has the wool mixed in and stuff. But combined with these two, I thought that would look beautiful. And the structure of that vest is such that I think it'll be okay. It will hold. So I plan on using this for the top portion. And this is the colorway. Gooseberry. So it's a lovely green. I'm not a huge green fan, but apparently I buy in a lot of green clothes and I've been making a lot of green things. So the top part of the vest is going to be this color and the bottom part's going to be this, because if the bottom part stretches, that'll be okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and make that. I've decided it is still very much what this yarn is calling for. I need to get on these though. I mean, you know, here's the problem. Like all this stuff you should be making, all the stuff in the winter, like your winter stuff, like these vests and stuff, you should be making now for winter. But when it's almost 100 degrees out, you don't wanna be making it. So I need to get over that and just make stuff. So, okay. I need to speed this up. I only have one more thing in a bag that you haven't seen lately. you'll love this bag. This is my Paxton and Whitefield London Cheesemongers bag. I actually got this bag in Bath just this past summer. And it had, oh, there goes my dog. It had cheese in it. And we were riding the train from Bath to London. And I we had gone, like, we were like, oh, we need some snacks because it's going to be a while. So we went into this cheese shop in Bath, and they have one in London too. And we bought some cheese and crackers and some, like, jammy stuff, and, you know, had some other little bits and bobs that we were carrying in this bag. And my husband's like, oh, we can give this bag to someone. I was like, yeah, give him that bag to someone, that's a new knitting bag. So yeah. And what is in here, I'm not going to show you every color, but basically, it's a bunch of Shep's yarn. It's a bunch of it. Like, the bag is halfway full of different chips. And the reason I have all of this, and there's not an easy way to show you. I mean, do you see all that? Okay, there it is. Yeah. It's a bunch of colors in chips. And the reason I have it is I bought this book, Knitted Wild Animal Friends by Louise Crowther. There it is. I bought it thinking, oh, I'll knit little Atticus something. But in reality, I was like, I want this monkey. So I bought the book. I bought all the yarn to knit this monkey. And I just need to knit it. So I'm definitely keeping this one because, it's like, I just need to do it. And I realized, like, really, this would be a good project to take while traveling. Not take all the yarn, but just take the what I need for each piece. So, like, you do the monkey, and then, I can, like, take that, work on the monkey, then next time do the little sweater or the shoes. So, I'm really, I saw that. I love monkeys. You're never too old to have a stuffed monkey. So, and there were some other things in here. I was like, okay, my daughter loves elephants, so how cute would that be? So, I don't have the yarn for that, but I mean, this book seems like there's a lot in here that I could do. And at some point I thought, well, you know, Atticus will be old enough, I can make something out of here for him. So, all right, so I have some other knitting bags, but they have my current projects. So I have one right here I can show you, but I'm not gonna take the project out. It's the alpaca my bag. This has the big rug in it that I've been working on, procrastinating on. I haven't done anything on it, by the way, because it's too hot. It's the big wool, bulky wool. So then I have another one, the beautiful knitter's bag. It's over there. That has the yarn for my Stephen West mystery sock along, surprise sock along. I'm almost caught up on that. And tomorrow the last clue comes out. And so I'm guessing I will be totally done by next week. So you probably will get another video next week at some point. And then I don't have the other project I'm working on in a bag. It's just kind of sitting out and I'm almost done with it. It's the Penguono shawl by Stephen West. I only have three rows to go and then I do the bind off. So I'm very close on that. So hopefully you'll have that done by next week too. I have a lot of other projects that I want to work on, but I don't have those projects in bags. So we'll go through another time and do another one of these. But I hope you enjoyed this. If you liked it and you enjoyed it, please give me a thumbs up and follow, subscribe to my channel if you wouldn't mind. I hate to beg, but I've got very few viewers and I would love to have more viewers, but so just subscribe, like all the usual. If you want to follow me on Instagram or Ravelry, I'm on both under Bobbleheadknits. And thanks for sitting through that. I've got a lot to get knitting on, so that's what I'm going to do. I hope you all stay cool, try to knit, and have a great week, and thank you for joining.